get that. We're going to prove to y'all that God only came for the nation of Israel. And there's no confusion, because when Christ left, these were things that were set up. Go ahead. This is the book of Acts, chapter 1 and verse 6.
Read up.
When they, therefore, were come together, they asked of him. These are the apostles coming with Christ, the disciples. Go ahead. Saying, Lord, would thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel?
To who?
To Israel.
The disciples asked Christ after he already died. Christ had already died. So if Christ died and God loves everybody and that was set forth, why are the disciples confused? Read that again.
When they therefore were come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel?
So they're talking about rebuilding the old ways, bringing back the old ways. Because in that time, when King David and King Solomon ruled, all the nations, we were against them. And they was either fighting them or they were serving us. But there was no such thing as equality.
Right.
So that's what the disciples are talking about right here. They're talking about when we will get our heaven back. When do we get our kingdom back?
Right.
That's a kingdom. Give me Luke 4 and 16. And y'all find the one in, I think it's Isaiah 47. It's the precept for Luke 4 and 16. Talk about the good tidings.
This is the book of Luke, chapter 4 and verse 16. And he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up. And as his custom was,
this is Jesus Christ, it was a custom for him to go where?
He went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day.
So Christ, as a custom, goes into the synagogue on the Sabbath day, which is Saturday. 61, all right, cool. Now let it keep going.
And stood up for to read.
So Christ read.
And there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah.
So Christ read out of Isaiah. What do you read?
And when he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me.
So Christ said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon him, meaning he's not lying, because the Holy Spirit does not lie. Go ahead.
Because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor.
Preach the gospel to the poor.
He hath sent me to heal the brokenhearted.
Go ahead.
To preach deliverance to the captives and recovering of the sight to the blind.
So preaching deliverance to the captives. So remember that, because when you hear that, you'll think, oh yeah, that sounds so good, because I know a lot of Chinese people, a lot of white people, they need to be delivered too, because they're captives, right? But let's go back to what Isaiah said. We're going to read to y'all what Christ was speaking of. This is called precept upon precept, line upon line, here a little and there a little, all right?
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 61 and verse 1. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me.
Go ahead.
Because the Lord hath anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek.
That sounds like the same thing Christ was reading, right? Keep going.
He hath sent me to bind up the brokenhearted.
All right.
To proclaim liberty to the captives.
Go ahead.
And the opening of the prison to them that are bound.
So the ones that are bound is us. Go ahead.
To proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord.
Keep going.
And the day of vengeance.
The day of what?
The day of vengeance.
Go ahead.
Of our God.
Of our God. And if you understand the Old Testament, you know that we know for sure that God was dealing with only Israel.
Right.
So we say our God. We can't play around with this. Keep going.
To comfort all that mourn.
Go ahead.
To appoint unto them that mourn in Zion.
Keep going.
Hold on.
In Zion. Go ahead.
To give unto them beauty for ashes. The oil of joy for mourning.
Because he's going to clean us up. We broke the laws of God, but once we keep the laws of God, God is going to come and save us and clean us up, put us back in our position. Keep going.
The garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness.
Go ahead.
That they might be called trees of righteousness.
Keep going.
The planting of the Lord, that he might be glorified. And they shall build the old ways.
The old ways, that's what he was talking about.
Jesus.
Go back to the old ways.
Right.
That's what the disciples were talking about. At this time, we restore the kingdom again unto Israel. So Christ was reading, restore the old ways of Israel.
Raise up former desolation.
They're going to raise up the old desolations. The temple's going back up. Everything's going to be set back the way it was in the time of Solomon, the time of peace. Keep going.
And they shall repair the waste cities.
Go ahead.
The desolations of many generations.
Go ahead.
And strangers shall stand.
So the strangers, now we're talking about strangers, because we know we're talking about Israel and Isaiah. Now we're going to talk about the other nations. We're going to see what their position is, because this is a future prophecy.
Right.
Keep going.
And strangers shall stand and feed your flock.
It said the strangers are going to feed your flocks. That's what Christ was reading.
Right.
That's what the kingdom is.
Right.
Strangers are going to feed your flocks because you're going to have your land now. You don't got it now. You're going to have your livestock. You're going to have everything you need to build this nation back up. All right? You don't have that right now because we lost it, because we broke the laws of God.
Right.
We continue to break the laws of God, and we're comfortable with it. But keep going. And the sons of the aliens, the sons of the strangers, shall be your plowmen. Shall be your plowmen. Yeah. That's a possession. They're going to be the ones in your field, like we were in their fields.
Right.
We picked their cotton, all their fruits, all their tobacco, sugarcane, what have you. We did that. And Christ said, they're going to do it to us if we keep the commandments.
That's
keep going.
And your vine dressers.
And your vine dressers. You so-called Hispanics don't have to pick no more. You keep the laws of God, you never have to worry about going to another field. A lot of other nations are going to go into the fields and pick the stuff that you pick.
Right, right.
You have to worry about sitting under a shade and putting a hat on your head because you're tired. That's not going to be you no more.
Right.
Keep going.
You're going to be named the priest of the Lord.
You're going to be priest of the Lord God. All the other nations are going to answer to you. They're going to bring their sacrifices to you. Keep going.
Men shall call you the ministers of our God.
They're going to call you the ministers. Because right now we look to other nations as being ministers. We hold on to every word they say. All right? Because when we come out here as so-called black men, when we come out reading the Bible, everybody takes us as a joke. Because they don't take the black man serious.
Right.
If it ain't coming from a white man, nobody cares. All right? Keep going.
Ye shall eat the riches of the Gentiles.
We're going to eat their riches.
Right.
They're going to bring their stuff to us.
Right.
The same way you pay taxes in this world today. The same way when you get a check and they take all the taxes out and you can barely live. The same would be for them.
Right.
And gotta come back around. Keep going.
And in their glory shall you boast yourselves.
Right.
For your shame, you shall have double.
Double. Give me that. Keep going to Revelation. Revelation 13. Get that. I'm gonna prove to y'all that's in the New Testament right now. All this stuff, this whole Bible adds up. Nothing's gonna contradict. All right? With the Spirit of the Lord, you get understanding by keeping the commandments. We'll get that next. Read this.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 13 and verse 10. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity.
The people that led you into captivity, they have to go into captivity according to the Bible. There's no such thing as, I can do wrong to you, but then we're even Stephen. God's going to wash that away. That's not in the Bible. Read that again.
He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killed with the sword.
Because we keep getting killed daily. And you're probably thinking it's not being shot by guns or by drugs, but it's by drugs. They're the ones pumping drugs in your communities.
Right.
That's what's happening. They're the ones that's putting you in low-income areas where you can't get a good education, and the only thing you can think you could be is a damn athlete or a damn singer.
Right.
And if not that, then you're pumping drugs in your community. That's the only way you can make a living for yourself.
Right.
He that killed with the sword must be killed with the sword.
He said these same people must be killed with the sword. All right, now give me Psalms chapter 111, verse 10. Because the reason, the way we're going to get out this whole condition is if we hearken to the Lord, to hearken to the words of the Lord thy God.
Right.
All right, because he only got it for us. God only cares for us. Go ahead.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 111, and verse 10.
Bring it up.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
So in order to get wisdom, in order to begin to get the knowledge, you have to what? Fear the Lord. How do you fear the Lord?
A good understanding have all they that do his commandments.
So the fear of the Lord is keeping the commandments of God.
Right.
Keeping the simple commandments. Give me Leviticus 19 and 11. Let's start there. This is the easy way to get the kingdom. All right? These are not hard to do. As long as you stay in the Spirit of the Lord, it's easy. Go ahead.
This is the book of Leviticus, chapter 19 and verse 11.
No.
Ye shall not steal.
That's the easy one, right? And that's an easy one. If you see your brother leave his wallet on there and he got some money, don't take it. Don't take it. Don't go into a man's car while he's not there. Take anything. Don't take nothing that does not belong to you.
Right.
These are things we brought up learning as children. What's the next one?
Neither deal falsely.
Don't deal falsely. Don't try to finesse your brother. Don't try to say something and twist your words around so it can seem a certain way. And but you know at the end, you're going to get the better of the deal. Don't trick your brother. What's the next thing?
Neither lie one to another.
Don't lie to your brother. These are simple things. If I don't want to be lied to, I'm not going to lie to somebody else. That's how we take care of each other. That's what love is.
Right.
Let me do Deuteronomy chapter 22. That's how you build a nation. If I deal righteously with my brother, most likely he's going to do the same way. That's how we keep a good accord. All right? Read that. Verse 1.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22 and verse 1.
What we're going to read is nation building.
Thou shalt not see thy brother's ox or his sheep go astray and hide thyself from them.
So if you see your brother's ox or his sheep or whatever property he has and it's gone, you're not going to sit there and not say nothing about it. You're not going to know about it and don't tell your brother. Keep going.
From them, thou shalt in any case bring them again.
It says in any case you're going to bring it to your brother. Any case means even if my brother pisses me off and my brother did something wicked to me, even though I can't stand him right now, if I see his ox go astray, I'm going to make sure he gets that ox back. Why? Because an ox in that time is used for plowing the field. If he can't plow the field, how's a man going to eat?
Right.
How's a man going to make a living?
Right.
That shows hatred, because you let that man fall, he's going to be poor now. You're going to have to go to another nation to serve that time. Right. Keep going.
Thou shalt in any case bring them again unto thy brother.
Let's go.
And if thy brother be not nigh unto thee,
go ahead.
Or if thou know him not.
If you don't know your brother, if you see something, if you found something that's not yours, and you don't know whose it is, go ahead.
Then thou shalt bring it unto thine own house.
Take it to your house. But go ahead.
And it shall be with thee unto thy brother, seek after it.
Now, if you hear on the news that somebody's looking for something and it fits that description, then you get that brother call. Hey, brother, I see you was looking for this. I don't know you, but I think I found what you're looking for. I think I have it. And you deal with your brother. All right? He's going to appreciate that. Keep going.
And thou shalt restore it to him again.
You restore it to him. You give it back because it's not yours. Keep going.
In like manner shalt thou do with his ass, and so shalt thou do with his raiment,
go ahead.
And with all lost things of thy brothers which he hath lost.
It don't matter what it is. Whatever it is of your brothers, you're going to give it back to him. Keep going.
And thou hast found, shalt thou do likewise. Thou mayest not hide thyself.
Go ahead.
Thou shalt not see thy brother's ass or his ox fall down by the way.
Go ahead.
And hide thyself from them. Thou shalt surely help him to lift them up again.
Go ahead.
The woman.
Hold on. So this is nation building. This is what I'm talking about. If I establish a good relationship with my neighbors, then we're going to deal righteously with each other. Because we understand nation building. If I have children and that man has children, then most likely we're going to try to get our children to get married. Why? Because we're on the same mindset. We're on one accord, keeping the laws of God. I know that man's not, I know he's going to teach his son not to deal deceitfully with my daughter. That's why. Now, that's nation building. Keep going.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
That's another one. This also goes into nation building. People are like, well, we just talked about oxen and asses, right? What does wearing stuff have to do with anything? Read it again.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
Go ahead.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
Go ahead.
For all that do so are abomination unto the Lord thy God.
Right, let's break that down, because we're still talking about nation building. If a man is wearing a woman's garment and a woman is wearing a man's garment, that's cross-dressing.
Right.
And most likely, they have the spirit of Sodom, homosexuality. Now, here's the key. Can two homosexuals produce a child? Can two homosexuals produce a child? No. That's why that's not nation building. In order to build a nation, you have to produce children.
What is a nation? Nation is men leading by example. Nation is family. Nation is community. Nation is children with role models.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord. His word.